नमस्ते व्यूवर्स, वेलकम टू सुनीता किचन स्टोरीज। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रिपेयर ए कर्नाटका स्पेशल डिश। इट इज कॉल्ड बस्सारु। इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ रसम। इंग्रेडिएंट्स फॉर दिस आर आई हैव टेकन वन बाउल ऑफ मुरुंगा लीव्स, ड्रमस्टिक्स लीव्स। यू कैन यूज मिक्स्ड लीव्स ऑल्सो, दैट इज मिक्स्ड ग्रीन लीव्स। वन बाउल ऑफ ब्लैक आइड पीस। इट इज कॉल्ड हलसंदे काड़ो इन कन्नड़ा, कारामणि in Tamil, it is fresh one. This is fresh one. Then tur dal 1 cup, 1/4 teaspoon of methi seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. This gives thick consistency for the rasam, so better add the tur dal. Salt according to taste, required amount of water, coriander leaf, सांबर पाउडर रिक्वायर्ड अमाउंट, 1 teaspoon ऑफ जीरा, 1/2 teaspoon ऑफ पेपर, 2 pods ऑफ गार्लिक, 1 medium साइज ऑनियन, देन फाइनली चॉप्ड ऑनियंस फॉर टेम्परिंग, सम पॉड्स ऑफ गार्लिक, फ्रेशली ग्रेटेड कोकोनट 1/2 cup, डिजायर्ड अमाउंट ऑफ टैमरिन। फर्स्ट स्विच ऑन द स्टोव, कीप द वॉटर फॉर गेटिंग बॉइल। By the time water get boil, we will fry some ingredients for the masala. Take a kadai, switch on the stove, add a teaspoon of oil to it, let it get heated. Now oil is heated, we will add pepper first, then to it itself we will add the jeera, then to this we will add the garlic pods. Just mix it, then immediately we will add the cut onions. We will fry this, and for extra flavor you can add curry leaves also. If it is fresh, it will be good. Now this is done. We will switch off the stove, let it get cool. Now the water is started boiling. We will add the tur dal, methi and turmeric to it. To this itself we will add 2-3 drops of oil. Now let it boil. When it is boiling, you check the dal. When it is half done, yes, it is breaking. At this stage we will add this black eyed peas. Now to this we will add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now let it cook. This bean should be cooked. Now we will check whether the beans is cooked or not. It is half cooked. At this stage we will add the moringa leaves. You can use any bean for that matter, hyacinth bean. Yeah, you can prepare this using beans, cabbage, anything you can prepare following the same process. Let the moringa leaves cook. Now we will check whether all the ingredients are cooked or not. See, they have cooked. At this stage what we will do, switch off the stove and close the lid and allow it for 10 minutes so that all the ingredients will blend nicely. Now open the plate, take out the plate. It is perfectly done. See, everything has become perfectly cooked. Now what we will do, take a strainer like this, take the strainer, keep it on a vessel. Now transfer this mixture into it and we will separate the water and the this dal leaves mixture. Now I have transferred all the ingredient in this. See, water has separated. Both have separated. I will allow for some time so that remaining water will drain it into the vessel. Then we will cool this mixture and we will squeeze it out the remaining whatever little water will be there in this. Now take a mixie jar, transfer the fried masala, whatever we fried, onions, jeera and pepper, transfer this. To this itself we will add sambar powder. I have taken 2 tablespoons of sambar powder. You use according to your requirement. Then to this itself we will add tamarind piece, then coriander leaves. Then to this what we will do, we will add this boiled mixture. It enhances the taste. Just a 2 tablespoons of the boiled mixture. Now we will grind this into a fine paste. Now I have grinded the masala into a fine paste, adding the required amount of water. Now what we will do, we will add this masala into the drained water. Now I am going to add the grinded masala into the water. Mix it thoroughly. Add all the masala to it. Mix it. Then we will cook this mixture. Now this mixture is cooled. What we will do? We will squeeze it out. The remaining water also. And keep this in a separate plate. Show some more. See, squeeze like this. The remaining water will come out. Then only the dish preparing from this will be nice. We are going to prepare a side dish. It will be very tasty. See, keep it in a plate. Continue the same with all the ingredient. Now I have separated the water from the mixture by squeezing. We will add this water to this rasam mixture only. Mix it thoroughly. Then we will cook this until the raw smell disappears. Now I have kept the rasam mixture on the stove and switch it on. To this we will add required amount of salt for the rasam. I am going to add a 1.5 teaspoon of salt. Let it boil until the raw smell of the masala disappears. Meanwhile, by the time the rasam get ready, we will prepare this side dish. For this, first we will smash the garlic pods. Just smash it. That's it. Now for preparing the side dish, take a kadai, keep it on the stove, switch on the stove. Now we will add a tablespoon full of oil to it. Add the oil and let it get heated. Now the oil is heated. Add mustard seeds, 1 spoon. Jeera seeds, 1 spoon. Then smashed garlic. To this, red chilies. Actually, I forgot to show this while showing the ingredients. You can add red chilies or green chilies also. According to your desire, you can add this. Give a nice mix. then what we will do, we'll add the finely chopped onions to it. Now we will cook this until the onions are done. See here, rasam is almost done. Now side by side, I am preparing the side dish also. Now once the onions turn pink, we will add the required amount of salt to the onions. Here I am going to add a teaspoon of salt. Mix it thoroughly. Then to this we will add this mixture. Mix it. Give a nice mix so that all the onions and the this mixture of black eyed bean, toor dal, murang leaf, mix thoroughly. Now the rasam is done. We will switch off the stove and we will give tempering finally. Here the side dish is ready, almost ready. I have mixed it thoroughly. To this, for extra taste, we will add freshly grated coconut. This is optional. Now mix it thoroughly. It is also done. Now I have kept oil for tempering. We will add hing to it. You can do tempering according to your desire. You can add garlic also. I prefer hing, so I am adding hing to this itself. Mustard seeds. If you have fresh curry leaves, you can give that also. Now let it sputter, then we will add this to the rasam. Now this is done. We will add this into the rasam. Now the tasty rasam and the side dish is ready to serve. Now the very healthy bassaru, that is rasam and side dish, is ready to serve. It is very healthy. This is the season you will get the fresh beans. You can try this. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel, Sunita's Kitchen Stories. Thank you.